Good evening, everybody. I hope everybody's having a wonderful, wonderful hump day. It is time for some more Alan Wake 2. Been really enjoying this game. I was having a conversation with some people today, and I have decided that the one level that we started with Alan Wake yesterday is probably the best level in a video game I've ever played. So far. Like, as far as, like, a single wall-to-wall level, the best. Oh my god, like, and it's just in that level that has stuck with me. Stuck with me so nicely. And, like, I'm gonna talk about that level for years to come. But we have some more Alan Wake content to get through, and I'll probably start the end game with Saga after we catch up with Saga's quest. I think we have, like, one more to do. So, let's get off this loading screen. Let's get to work as Alan Wake. So our goal now is to get to Parliament Tower, which is our apartment, which is this one there. So today I got myself a tasty treat. It's kind of a weird one. It is dill pickle flavored pepperoni sticks. This is a risk. All of this is a risk, but I'm hungry. Because we just finished working out. And we got this for edible night. It's a choice. I think this is where we're at Parliament Tower, right? That's not what I wanted the map. I guess if you can't get in the registry, you can't get in the map.
Go to hell!
Here we go.
Needed to get inside the manuscript.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, it's an effect of the game. Circling, now they want to turn what happened to Al into a movie or a TV show, or get this, a fucking video game. Oh my god, the meta narrative on this. Yeah. Okay, is that both of the boys, or?
I think this came from Jay. I'll double check with Danny.
Okay, cool. Well, double check with Jay if both of the boys are invited.
Yeah.
Birthday stuff. Sorry, but dude, the meta narrative in this is insane. I love it. Also, in case you want to hear about this from, in case you hear about this from someone else, or a true crime writer named Tammy Booker was working on a book about Al. I hunted down her publisher and told them we'll sue. Don't worry, I got you covered. Hey, Alice, checking in because I hear you haven't heard from you. Everything good back there? I've been trapped in non-stop meetings with no breaks. Open kimono. I have been considered peeing in a mug, and lunches be damned. How do these people ever get a movie made when all they do is sit in meetings is beyond me? Joined a cult. Hey, Alice, you're going to have to think I've been replaced by an evil double, but I have joined a cult and I love it. Joking about it being a cult, kind of. Blessed wellness retreat. Working with Al or the Andersons was tough sometimes, but these movie biz types are insane. My stress levels were through the roof, but then I was tipped off about the retreat. The best decision I ever made. I've never felt this good. Chester's a goddamn miracle worker, not a wacko in any way. I know you think I'm full of shit. I've lost a ton of weight. You wouldn't recognize me. Chester says I'm lucky to have ended up here, and that something bad would have happened if I stayed in New York. I believe him. I wasn't feeling great after everything that happened, especially those FBC creepos wanted to chat with me enough to turn anybody into a conspiracy nut. Hope you're good over there. Come visit me West Coast. Not as bad. Hollywood people are fake. Okay, cool. So that was the talks with Barry. A movie, a book, or get this, a video game. The audacity. Go!
For months after Ellen died, I didn't leave the apartment. I was flattened by the confusion, shock, the guilt. Fear. I could barely get out of bed. Barry Wheeler started visiting. He even cooked me meals.
He's a predator.
I couldn't stand the guy when I first met him, but he's a better friend.
Typical agent shit. God damn it, Barry.
He still checks in. Even after he moved out west.
Alice's work had consumed the apartment, her whole life.
Oh, and that's number three. We need number two.
One morning, I saw a deer soar past my bedroom window. It was a balloon of some cartoon animal. And I looked out at the street below, and I saw a little girl crying. Like losing that balloon had just ended her whole world. It was the perfect image of the horror of caring. And that's when I got myself out of bed. And I picked up my camera.
All right, now you find number three, which is right here.
There was something in the dark. Something I needed to see, to show. The more shadows I photographed and filmed, the more I felt like I was on the verge of a breakthrough. I submerged myself in it. I only went out at night. My search became obsessive, but I still had no idea what I was looking for.
Wonders?
There's TV number four. Holy shit.
There's a world hidden behind ours. A dark tide ebbing and flowing against reality. Faces in the shadows. Fear of the dark is really just fear of what could be. That vast, paralyzing ocean. But photography? Can freeze reality in a snapshot, put a cage around the infinite and capture it. I need to prove those faces are really there.
Every time the live action parts kick up, you know some wild shit's about to happen. Thought maybe the game had broken or something. I couldn't move.
The full manuscript of a novel. Return. A horror story about the dark presence escaping from the dark place, taking over Bright Falls. I couldn't remember writing it. I had not written it. I would never write this. I knew who had. Scratch, a monster with my face. If this story came true, Scratch would get out, people would die. Destroying the manuscript, it wouldn't stop it from happening. I would have to fix it, edit it. I could not change the genre of the story. I'd have to work within the constraints set by Scratch. I needed someone in the story to fight the darkness. Saga Anderson. I kept seeing her in my visions. She was already in Bright Falls, already involved, but she was not in Return. Not yet. I'd write her in, try to stop Scratch within the limits of the horror story. It was almost impossible. It was taking too long. I had not reached the end. Scratch stopped me before I could finish my edits to the manuscript.
Fuck Scratch. Am I gonna be a dick?
The memory of my edits was already fading. Terrible things would happen if the manuscript came true. Scratch was there, at Parliament Tower, undoing my work. He could use the story to escape. He could go after Alice. Zane has said we worked on Return together. That was a lie. Scratch wrote Return. I would pay Zane another visit. He had guided me to two murder sites. I needed a new one to get back to Parliament Tower. A new draft of initiation.
Okay, so it's the studio now, but it's wet. Alright, let's see. What's Mr. Door got for us? What's Mr. Door got in store?
I don't have time for this, so let's get it over with. Tell me, was this all fake? A show?
No one said otherwise, Mr. Wake.
Shit.
It was to indulge you, but we can stop pretending now.
Masks come off.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far. I don't even think you know who's under your mask, but you know how to make things difficult for yourself. All these rules, endless, convoluted loops you insist on going through.
Sorry.
You are so lucky, you know. There are so many people out there. Armies of people. Myself. Your wife.
I need to get to her. She's in danger.
She is. Because of you.
Way to go, Alan.
Someone important to me, someone you pulled into this. You keep opening doors. People. reaching through to get what you want, and that puts you in my path.
I don't know what you're talking about. I have to go now.
Maybe you will make it through this time. This has gone on long enough. This and our Night Springs, it was a nice distraction.
It's time someone gave me a straight answer here.
The next time we meet, the circumstances will be very different. And you would do well to return the favor by playing your part. Or stay out of my way, Mr. Wake.
Whatever you say.
Door, Zane, the masks were finally coming off. Was it a sign I was closer to escaping? I had no time to waste.
Video exit. I just want to make sure I'm not missing any little bits.
Wake.
Oh, whoops. You didn't see me.
Ellen, wake. You will never escape.
Wake. Okay, that's the correct way. So now we go off the beaten path, just to be sure.
Wake.
You guys got anything in here?
Wake.
Uh-oh. Okay, cool. Fucker. Stop being creepy.
Wake.
Damn it.
I couldn't get in. I was missing something.
Ellen, wake.
Interpretation of many words. That's been there the whole time. I feel like it's a clue to something. Anything over here? Oh. I don't think this wet dry vac's gonna fix this water problem.
Tom. Votako on vaan, set the granny in the snow. When the panic is biggest, the help is also near.
Dor didn't seem happy to see me this time.
Fearing the master is the root of wisdom. But don't let the game get you down. He's playing his role. Maybe put him in your films, Tom, like you have put me. Sehän olisikin.
What films?
I'm a fan of your masterworks. There is Tom the Poet, my favorite. And Yö den Yö is the most famous one, of course. And is it true what I hear? That it's coming back to cinema soon? Is there a bottom to this rumor?
I need to get back to my apartment. Can you help me?
Well, plan is half done. You asked me to make sure you won't forget the light pictures. The photos your artist wife took. They are waiting in the shoebox in the basement. what you leave behind, you find in front of you.
Okay. Thanks, Adi.
Find the shoebox in the basement. What's over here? That's a door. Also a door. What? Didn't I find it?
To get to Parliament Tower, I needed to find a murder site. Zane would know where to find one.
Oh, there it is. Match it up.
This messy maze of blood trails I was chasing the cult through, I ran into the filmmaker, Thomas Zane, an esoteric bohemian with a hard-on for acts of cruelty performed in the name of occult nonsense. A director wants to control every aspect of the world in their films. Is a cult leader any different? Was he just another alias? For scratch. There was a rumor that Wake and Zane had been working on something together. I was going to get the truth out of Zane with whatever means necessary.
Wake.
Purpose to be a demon, to sort the clues based on my interpretation, to change that which I observed. It was all a play, shadows on the wall of a cave, an echo of the true events that happened somewhere else. Was I there to watch the shadows, or was I a shadow too, in a performance set up for someone else?
Alright, into the hotel we go.
Zane's room, 665, was upstairs. The elevator would take me there.
Okay. 665, here's his room.
Something told me Zane wouldn't be happy to see me this time.
Let's see what we got.
I'm in control now. The second you try anything, I will shoot you in the head. Scratch wrote return, not me. You're a fucking liar.
You'd given up. You stopped writing.
You said it was too dangerous, that we didn't deserve to get out. And then he showed up. Scratch. He promised to write. To get me the hell out of here.
He was... you have a good night, kiddo.
A visionary. I mean, it was art. But then, when he finished, he took return and left me behind. It's still here, and so is he. I know I fucked up. But you can still catch him before he gets out. Before he gets to your wife. When you get to him, don't hesitate. Kill the bastard for what he did to us. There's a murder site
in my cinema, where my film Nightless Night is playing.
I told you not to try anything!
Alright, Poet Cinema.
I had to find the movie theater Poet Cinema. The next murder site was there. Zane had created the film in tandem with Return to escape the dark place.
Where's the elevator? Where am I? Here we go. Okay. Take the skyway, I guess. Trying to remember where I gotta go from here. I think it's here. Is there a door here? Okay. Okay, let's try the hotel again. Oh, here we go. Thank you.
cry if you stay here for too long. You'll end up a lost soul, haunting the streets and alleys, a faded out shadow.
Ah, fuck, I didn't finish it. Just gotta sit there and finish it. I don't know why I get so impatient.
This city will suck you dry if you stay here for too long. You'll end up a lost soul, haunting the streets and alleys. A faded out shadow, glimpsed by some other poor bastard on his way toward the same fate. Your broken dreams become a broken mirror, and the twisted reflection staring back at you with all the pent-up anger, regret, guilt, and shame was the monster you could never get away from.
I think I took the longest possible way to get to where I'm going. This should take me down to the bottom. Just take, what is this? Yeah, that's a fuck up. Back in. Damn it. Get in the room. There we go. Now, technically, I did exit the hotel, but I took the wrong exit. So let's try this again. Because we missed the elevator button. Oops.
Beams of the movie theater on the far side of the plaza.
Spotlights in the sky. Hey! Stop it! Fuck! At least I saved. For the audio. Stop knifing me, bro. Always remember to keep your Magnum bullets cool. Dark monsters can't duck. Taking me, son of a bitch. Well, this is a bad start. We're good. Everybody chill the fuck out. Yeah. Oh, I'm happy it turned into shotgun bullets this time. Flashlight's going to be an issue in a bit. Okay, we're not going to go into the alley this time. We're going to try the front door first. Get inside is the command.
The theater appeared to be closed.
Easier said than done.
The ticket could still get me in.
Batteries are good. Get a little worried about those. Okay, nothing in here. Nothing in here. Here. Alright. So the ladder's in the other side. There it is, that's what I want.
Something kept me going. A broken man. No hope, no prospects, no love. Too stubborn to die. Like a cockroach with a misguided sense of honor and justice in a city where there can never be justice.
Force it open.
Fair enough.
The cinema lobby was a gateway to other realities on the silver screen. I could set a scene here.
Case I'd ever been on. They would surface from the dark with their
worst Casey, final Casey,
and fade back into Casey, the night, leaving behind bloody crime scenes and clues heavy with obscure meanings that led nowhere. Arriving at the cinema, I felt a monumental, terrifying revelation trembling before me, ready to open its jaws and swallow me whole.
This place had significance to the cult. There was something to use there.
Now, before we go crazy here...
The question is, how do you run from an idea, from a thought, from a story that lives in your head? You can't escape your fears. You carry your monsters with you. The devil, the dark, it's in you. You're running.
Anything else over here? What do we got here? What's in the freezer? Nothing! Thanks. Thanks, game. Appreciate it.
Did I stop writing at some point? I can't stop. There's too much at stake.
Now we can comfortably. No, we can't. Ooh, that's a lot of good stuff. Let's fuck with the plot board.
I needed a new draft of the story. One that would get me ahead of Scratch. The first step toward the murder site. I was making progress.
Yeah, looking good so far. Up the stairs, I believe, is going to be our next move.
I was missing something. Someone had barricaded themselves in the room. My writing was affecting reality.
Would do him a lot of good to talk, but
an initiation ceremony, or so we made our new members believe. Two of New York's finest, they had performed endless favors to earn their place among us. We had something special waiting for them, and something very special for you, Alex Casey.
Who's your leader? Alan Wake? Scratch? Zane? Give me a name!
You will meet him soon enough.
There was no end to the corruption. It fit the genre, so I'd use it.
Oh, now that door is open. Nope, this one is not open. Never mind. I rescind my sarcasm.
Alan Wake. There is nothing.
following awaits you. Following your master into La La Land. A sad bunch of clowns in funny masks and hoods, pretending to be a secret society.
Maybe it is you who's playing a role, Mr. Casey. A role carefully laid out for you. The puppet, blindly performing the ritual steps for the glory of the cult. Huh?
What the fuck have you been smoking?
Nightless Night. A clip of the Lost Film survived. You will see, Mr. Casey. In the Nightless Night, you will finally see.
Nightless Night was Zane's film. It played a role in this story.
We can get up on the stage here? Hold on a second.
Some claimed it was a snuff film, that the ritual murder in the film was an actual murder. There were no known surviving copies, but the cult chased it as if it were their unholy grail. Just like Wake's books were.
Wake!
Good scene for dark deeds.
That's why I'm gonna save. So that those dark deeds don't kill me and make me lose progress. Oh, excuse me. So,
I'm sure I had the answer on the plot board.
Alan, you know, fucking give me a chance to explore. Again.
To the roof, you say? Find a way into
someone had fallen to their death from the rooftop.
Okay, let's try a different storyboard. Upward. Let's try New York's Finest.
The police car felt important to the story. I was making progress.
This initiation, do you?
I'm sure we'll just chant some ceremonial stuff. Nothing to it.
Well, it's about time. We paid our dues, made plenty of their problems disappear, dumped all those nobodies down that chute.
What we did or didn't do, it's all behind us now. We're going straight to the top, partner.
Yep, like we died and went to heaven.
got here?
In the city trapped in eternal night, they watch the film where the night never arrives, where the night hides in your mind.
Is the door still locked for this one? Okay, I'll be right back. I gotta hit the washroom desperately. Here's some words. I'll give you the starter.
plot changes shake the world around me.
Alright, hold up. A little clip on the last film. What does that alley look like on the clip? Okay, so that doesn't change at all anywhere. Finest. We tried something, anything with a police car. Bingo! That's a great way to get off.
The dirty cops looked down at the city. Their city. They had committed repulsive deeds to get there.
Hmm.
got me, Mr. Casey. I'm all yours. Go ahead. Ask that burning question in your mind.
How did you do it? How did you get me into that film clip without my remembering it? Talk to me, damn it!
You've seen the film? Good, good. Now you're ready to meet the Grandmaster. He's waiting for you in the projection booth where everything will be revealed, where he will project a new reality onto this one. And now, Mr. Casey, I've played my part to the end.
No! No! Crazy bastard! Why'd he jump?
The projection booth. Was that where I find the murder site?
Get another save in for safety's sake.
It was locked from the other side.
Words of power, words of stuff. This seems correct. Oh, maybe not.
Thank you.
I hear. Let's try the last one there.
I changed the story. And with that, the dark place changed. A new element from here.
Oh.
I'd have to go to the scene.
Okay, chill out. I have no idea what I need to do. So I'm just sort of muddling my way through it. Thank you. this one that we had?
Hello.
Oh, hey, Alan. You snuck up on me.
Sorry. Have we met?
Memory problems again, huh? Yeah, we've met. Tim Breaker. We've shared notes. Hey, I've made some progress on the map, if you want to take a look. I still haven't found my mystery man, though. Well, that's my crazy wall. I'm just trying to make sense of things. Don't judge me.
I'll trade you walls any day.
There's the map. Beautiful.
You're making a map.
Trying to. It's hard to map a dream, though. I keep ending up in unexpected places. I find interesting things like those strange markings that react to the light. But never the one thing that I'm looking for. Feel free to check the map out. Oh, I've been stockpiling supplies while I poke around. If you find a stash, take anything you need.
I appreciate the help. Who's this mystery man?
Oh, it wouldn't be much of a mystery if I knew. All I have is a name. Warland Dorr.
The talk show host?
No. No, that doesn't sound like him. The guy has many disguises, but a talk show host? I'll keep looking.
Alright.
See you around, Alan.
Progress is progress, as they say. And now we have a map. Now we can find our way around. Okay, so that's not the way to go. Somehow I got myself fucking turned around up here. It's sort of driving me nuts. Just the one entrance here. The sign. Break room. We ended up fucking going around in a fucking circle, didn't we? How did I get myself so fucked up?
The scene changed with the story.
Door! Right there. Oh my god. Okay. Okay. Let's see how this goes. Fuck! Couldn't see shit.
The answer was close.
Oh boy, flashlight's out of batteries. Thank God for flares.
The scene, to see and understand it, in order to change it.
Fuck.
Okay, we need to get to... That's not gonna be through the washroom.
Shit.
Not clip of the lost film, is it?
Changing a plot element in a scene without being there was impossible.
This needs to be here.
This was dark, but the story had to be dark. In a maze of film equipment. There had to be a way to the projection booth from here. I wasn't alone.
Right.
I was back at the beginning again. I had to keep going. Find a way to the murder site.
Show yourself!
Casey?
Who's there? Look, you got the wrong guy. I'm not Alex Casey. I only play him in the movies. He's just a fictional character.
What's going on here?
You don't have to kill me. You don't have to go get that knife and stab me. You can just give up and go back. Forget about the ritual sacrifice to open the way forward.
The ritual sacrifice to open the way?
No. Don't do it. You don't have to become a monster.
Show yourself. We can run, but I'll get you. I'll get all of you, you fuckers.
A knife.
Oh no. Oh no, you don't. You'll be sorry.
Oh no.
What the fuck?
Guess he wasn't tied up all that well.
I was getting close.
Makes any sense is in your psychotic brain.
As a fictional character in a story, you've fulfilled your purpose. You've brought the writer of the story here. You can go now, Casey.
No, I'm not going anywhere before I get some answers. How was I in that movie? Why does all this feel so familiar? What? Who the fuck are you? Who the fuck am I? No!
Welcome to you, Alan Wake.
What the hell?
This is the ritual to lead you on. We are just one step away from your final destination, Mr. Wake. But first, here's an unanswered mystery for you. If Casey was fictional, and you assumed his role as a detective, are you now fictional too? Whose story are you living, Mr. Wake?
The visions were getting under my skin, coming too close for comfort. Not a separate layer, but mingling with my own reality in the dark place. Wait. Dead end. This can't be right. Did I miss something?
Colors fading in.
The murder site. The mask was the key.
I had to poop my pants. You pooped my pants.
Scratch wrote returned. I tried to fix the story, but he stopped me before I reached the end. He has it now. It's the key to escape.
What do you mean, escape? You can point with Scratch.
I need to stop him. I need to stop him before he gets out. He's after Alice. I'm still trapped, but I'm making progress. I wrote you in to be the story's hero. Scratch made a horror story. I need to match the genre. It has to be dark, but the hero can break through, save her family. Save us all.
Save her family. Are you talking about my family?
Yes. Whatever you're doing, it's working. You just need to keep going.
Did we have family in the horror story?
I was closer now. Closer than ever before. But there was no time to lose. Everything was hanging in the balance. I could still lose it all. Parliament Tower. I had to make it work this time. I could stop Scratch, get the manuscript, fix its ending.
Where are we at? 11:30? Yeah, still got time.
I was traveling deeper into the dark place. The poem on the wall was growing at the same pace, dogging my footsteps, like my unwanted shadow moving in the corner of my eye. It wasn't my writing. I didn't know what it was. A terrible prophecy, a curse looming over me.
Some more drawers here.
Closed. I had more questions now than at the start. The irony of being trapped in a postmodern detective story. I felt watched. The eyes of some unseen audience on me. I wanted to turn to the hidden camera and tell them to fuck off. But I didn't know where to look to break the fourth wall. There would always be another case for Casey. A million stories in this dark city. The night opened up to welcome me. I walked into her arms. Roll credits.
There we go. I'm in the fuck out of here. I want to check something quickly.
Gus, he is an uncaring, cruel son of a bitch. Having made it in heaven, he doesn't want us there, dirtying up all that nice white upholstery. And he doesn't want to reach down to help us. He gets his kicks just binge-watching us struggling, hurting, killing, dying, screwing it up again and again. Lazily stirring it up when things threaten to get too placid.
This city is only here to satisfy his sick, voyeuristic pleasure.
Okay. Okay, easy enough. Fair enough. Go.
Phone was ringing again. Somehow I sensed it wasn't Zane this time.
The fuck is the phone? Disappear, thank you.
Hello?
Hello.
It wasn't Zane. It wasn't Scratch either.
Me? I don't understand. There's a lot I don't understand.
A dark place operates in loops. Time is a story. I'm calling you from a different point in that story.
From the future? I'm never getting out of here, am I?
Yes, you will. And no, you won't. And that is by your own choice.
What does that mean?
I'm sorry for what you'll have to go through. You need to go back to the talk show studio basement. Get Alice's photos from a shoebox there. Before you can go to Parliament Tower, you must put the photos into the shoebox at her statue at the plaza. To help you, to help Alice, to help Saga Anderson.
I'm my own Deus Ex Machina? Really?
How many writers does it take to finish a story? One for each draft. It's the same writer, but in a different point in time. I follow the steps he laid out for me.
There's nothing there. Photos from the talk show studio basement. Okay.
Thank you.
Where are the photos?
Alice's photos. I recognize the style. One showed the clicker sinking into darkness. The other showed a light in the shape of a bullet. I need to get them to the plaza.
Next, we gotta find the TV room, which will lead us to a quick exit. Quick save.
The photos now. I needed to put them into the shoebox by the statue.
Alright, I'm being pushed back to Sokka. Okay. Cool. Where are we at now? Almost midnight? And here we gotta share the plan with Casey and Estefan. So we go back to the station.
I think you may be right. Might have been a mistake to come here. I don't think Marcy's coming back.
Fuck Riley.
Things don't matter. Just be
I'm sorry. Hey, it's not your fault. No. Doesn't make sense.
Police station. Okay. So Alan Wake
segments have pushed me back to Saga, which means we now have to enter the part of Saga where we're at a point of no return.
You were the better Koska. Much better than me.
There. There's a thermos in here too to save. Okay, I'm gonna be right back. We're gonna hit the words. I shall return with an emptier bladder. Oh, wait, we need to restart.
Mm.
Ready to go? I'm ready to head to Cauldron Lake now. Let's get the plan started.
Okay, here we go. We'll be there for you. What do you need from us?
I'll head to Cauldron Lake with the clicker.
Scratch will try to get you, Anderson. You'll need backup.
I can tell there's no talking you out of coming, Casey. Estevez, is there a way to get that light array to the lake?
Oh, I've got you covered, so good news there. And we'll bring our mobile containment unit. It's specially built for entities like Scratch.
And this work of art, Anderson. What's the plan for that?
I'll make some calls on the way. Just meet me at Cauldron Lake.
All right.
Tor, I need the old gods of Asgard. I need a very special song. You saw this coming, huh? Of course. I need a song about Alan Wake. About bringing him out of the dark place. I hope they've still got it. Another one of those cult boxes.
All right, we got the... Purple part pinch. Large. I have to do a full 100% run at some point in this game.
Don't like all this chaos right before Deerfest. Maybe I should just stay here for the night and make sure no harm comes to my creation.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
What do you know? You're just an apprentice. You have no idea the pressures a professional like me is under.
Damn. Man's gotta chill. Part of Cauldron.
Then you...
Let her. She's dead because of you. And I don't ever want to hear your voice again.
Oof.
Stop calling me.
David! Jesus Christ. It's getting worse. It's spreading. I'm running out of time.
I'm starting to worry that she's just out of her fucking mind.
Come on, Saga. Time to get back to work.
Wrong way. Fuck. That's right, okay. It's harder to navigate in the dark.
That must be Torn Odin. Maybe I should check in.
Kiddo! We're almost at the gig! And Odin's run over four minions of darkness! The boss is our hammer!
I'm driving with one hand!
I need you to meet me at the shore. Is the song ready?
Almost! Odin's got a tree!
What tree? There's no tree in the song!
Who the fuck puts a tree in the middle of the road? We're not on a road.
Drive carefully, Grandpa.
Pedal to the metal, bro! Metal!
down to the pedal. Yeah!
Very rock and roll way to drive.
Follow their trail of destruction. Now, I usually want to take a safety measure because I'm a lunatic. Let's take this one. All right. How much car is left? Rock, rock, tree, are you bright enough? Seven minus two. Oh, 3 plus 3, okay. Back to following the truck.
lights in the containment cell are good to go, Anderson.
Great. The Torin Ode in there yet?
The two golden oldies? Well, they're here. And they bought moonshine. I love them already.
They're a lot.
What art we would use? Well, that's them. I'll be there soon. Oh, another rhyme.
Mother Crow resting under her nest, guiding her babies, doing her best to protect her home from the beast coming to feast, but only a hero brave heart.
Big bunks.
Hey, Kana. Mother Crow sits in her nest, guarding her babies, doing. Do we have a crow? Crow doll. Mother crow in the nest. Monster.
Nope. Think, Saga.
Not bad. Trying to read this here. A mother crow sits in her nest, guarding her babies, doing her best to protect her home from the beast coming to feast. But only a hero brave of heart can keep the two apart. Okay, hold up. Hero doll is gonna go here. Hero doll is gonna go here. Monster doll.
No.
No?
Nah. That's not right.
Let's check something quick. There might be another doll around here. Yeah, this game, I'm really digging this game. This game's been really good. I've been really focused on it. Saw this right now. It's derailing me. Mother Crow sits in her nest, guarding her babies, doing her best. Crow doll. Monster doll.
Keep trying. Yeah.
There it is. Whoops. Come on now. Cool, I'd save that. Turned that into a save point. Nice. Mom's in home with child. See you gently here, stay between your feet, folks. Mm-hmm. You're reading poetry now? I never did find that key, did I? Where do those footprints go? There it is. Oh no. Use this one. Oh, a lot of, yeah, there's a lot of Resident Evil in this. It. I don't want to fight it.
One, two.
How you feeling tonight, cauldron? Wait. In a while.
The first one's really good. The second one is even better. Like, this has been my game of the year so far. But I also haven't been subjected to Baldur's Gate or, you know. I mean, I played Mario Wonder, but it's good, but it's... Mm-mm. Please don't kill me. Yeah, I don't think I have the time to put into Baldur's Gate, to be honest. It would take me like 10 months in streaming to beat it. Oh, shit. Okay, this is a problem. Go.
Testing. Gonna need more reverb. I'm getting no bounce out here.
Hey, where are my chimes?
I threw them out. Chimes are
not rock and roll.
Hey,
yeah, they are.
I'm here. Let's get ready.
Anderson, we've set up control center up here overlooking the area.
Anderson, I can drop more gear down for you if you're running low.
I'll use the lights to hit the Taken when they come. Light them up for you. Bad news is, we were in a hurry. The power supply is spotty. Your partner here will try to keep it running.
But I'm not a damn mechanic. I wish your tech guy was here, Karen.
Well, this game would take me months to always try to check. Yeah. And that is a game that, like,
at maximum volume,
really needs you kind of doing a little bit of everything. Okay, is there a way I can move this? You know what? I don't have a rifle.
We're waiting for your signal, Saga. This will be a show for the ages.
Just need to make sure I am fully equipped, that is all.
We're ready when you are!
Relax, Tor and Odin. I just need to make sure I don't immediately lose.
Grandpa, you signal me when the song is done, and I'll use the clicker to bring Wake back. Hit it!
Hello, Cauldron Wake! Great to see so many federal agents here tonight. Prepare to experience a soul-searing, mind-frying act of black magic and sorcery! This song goes out to our favorite tortured writer. Let these sweet tunes guide you out of the darkness. It's called Dark Ocean Summoning.
Making me look bad in front of Saga, bro.
Let's try that again.
Take an incoming, Anderson.
Where are they coming from?
Coming.
Eat a flare. Oh, dude, you should be with Alan Wake. Blindsided. Yeah, the first one had a big, like, there's actually one, same band, there's like a whole thing where you're supposed to, Resident Evil only inspired the combat. One of the best levels in this game involves more music, too.
I have them in the light.
Bruh.
I got him for you, Anderson.
On top of healing too. This is a little bit more chaotic than the game has been.
A whole lot of paranormal crimes happening right now. It's fucking
awesome. Oh yeah. Holy shit, this is a lot going on.
Anderson,
there's a lot going on right now. And this is like, we're getting towards the end of the game, so it's kind of throwing shit at me. Thank you. Fuck. Beat him to flare. Heal. I had so much shotgun ammo too. This is on normal difficulty too. The dodge has just been betraying me quite a bit. Oh, fuck off. Fuck off. Reload the fucking gun. Heal. Don't kill me, please. Load the fucking gun. Oh shit! Big dude! Thank you. Suck a flare down. Oh my god.
The power of rock and roll.
That was insane. Nailed it. What I'm gonna do, I go over here. I'm gonna save the game, because we're gonna be calling it for the night. And then, yeah. And then we could be approaching the end of the game come tomorrow, because where are we right now? We just finished summoning, so we have two more chapters for Saga. And I think we have one more for Alan Wake. So like three chapters left. So we finished four of the seven that we had left going into from yesterday. And tomorrow's an early start. It's an 8:30 start. So very likely to finish it. That was a heck of a last mission. But like, oh my god, the music in this game is so fucking good. Oh man. So yeah. No problem. Thank you for hanging out, Akana. I'll be back tomorrow night, 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, for a little bit of a longer stream, probably to finish the game. In the meantime, you have yourself a good night, and we'll see you tomorrow. Later.